Do you need to know how to record purchasing assets and how it's different than paying for expenses? Well, then you should watch this video, QuickBooks for Home Finance, Purchasing Assets. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. We know that the net worth would normally be equal to your total assets if you did not have any debt or any liability. But what is an asset anyway? Well, an asset is anything you own that has value. You could buy a car, you could buy a couch, you could even purchase stock. If you own it and it has value, it is an asset. So how do you record purchasing an asset? Well, it's very simple. You would record purchasing an asset the exact same way that you record paying for an expense. So you would use the checks window and the money would come from your bank account, and the account you would choose would be an asset account and not an expense account. And that's the only difference when you're paying for an asset. So how do you know that you have an asset at the moment that you're paying for it? How do you know that you don't have an expense? Well, the question is, when does the value expire? So at the moment you pay, if at the moment you pay, you have already used up the value, then you are paying for an expense. Like paying for a delivery that you already received, or paying for a repair at the moment the person fixes the object you're paying to have repaired. But if at the moment you pay, you still have some value that you can use into the future, then you have an asset. For example, let's imagine on October 10th of 2016, we paid Anna's dealership for an electronic bicycle and we paid $3,000. You can add the asset account and add the vendor on the fly. And adding on the fly means you add it at the moment you make the transaction. So it's very simple. Banking, write a check. And then October 10th of 2016. Now we don't have the name of the company here. What is it? Anna's Dealership? Anna's Dealership. So we can click the pull down. And if the person is not on the list, we can click add new. And this person is a vendor. So we can type just type the name for now and click OK, and that name will populate the name field. Now, what about the account? Is it an expense or an asset? Well, we know that it's an asset, so we have to come all the way up and click Add New. And the type of account is fixed asset, something that you are paying for today whose value will last you into the future. And click continue, and the name of the asset will be electronic bike. Or whatever you want to type in. Save and close. Now, the money amount you paid, $3,000. We click save and close, save anyway. You don't really have to assign a class to assets if you're doing home finance, because it doesn't really go on the profit and loss. It goes on the balance sheet instead. save anyway. Now, when you look at your trial balance, you have a new account in the chart of accounts, electronic bike, $3,000, and cash in bank has been reduced by $3,000. Example 2, October 11th, paid Fran's furniture for a couch, $2,000. You can add the asset account and the vendor at the moment that you make the transaction. So you click banking, write a check, and this is on October 11th of 2016. Fran's furniture is not on the list, so we click add new, vendor, and we type it in. And then we click OK. Now the asset is also not on the list, so we scroll to the top and we click add new, and it's a fixed asset, and it is a couch. And we click save and close, and we're paying $2,000 for this couch. Save and close, save anyway, because assets don't need a class when you're doing home finance. And you can see the couch now shows up for $2,000, and the cash in bank has been further decreased by the $2,000. Now, here's the question. Did your net worth change? And the answer is no. On your balance sheet, you simply have less cash and more of the other asset, and the net worth stayed the same. Watch. You click Reports, Company and Financial, Balance Sheet Standard, and you can see if we push, you know, we balance sheet all dates, you can see that we now have the couch and the electronic bike for $5,000, but when we scroll down, the total equity, the net worth, stayed the same and did not increase.